What's happening, guys? This is the Grandmaster of Faster, and welcome back to Let's Play LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. In the last episode, we managed to collect every mini-kit, piece, and power brick in Episode 4. So moving down the line, let's start The Empire Strikes Back. And we are going from one vehicle level to another. Yep, it's time for us to go back to the Hoth battle. Which is cool, because the Hoth battle is easily one of the best fights in the entire Star Wars saga. So starting things off, we want to become a snow speeder, obviously, because it has a tow cable. And we are going to start by blasting these two jerks, because I don't want droids tugging on my tow cable. We need to drop this bomb in order to progress anyway, so we might as well take care of it now. But if we head over behind this wall, we see an interesting looking container. And if we blast it, we get a mini kit piece. Now there's one more container like it on the other side of the area. But in order to get past it, we'll need to turn into a TIE fighter. And now that that's over and done with, we need to switch to another vehicle that has a tow cable. But first we need to get rid of all of these jerks because they'll only serve to get in our way. And admittedly, I am not driving very well at all. Okay, now if any droids grapple your bomb, you'll have to be sure to destroy them because, well, this can happen. Let's see if we can try that again. All right, I guess the Republic gunship is not going to work as far as crossing that gap is concerned. So let's go ahead and use the snow speeder instead. Destroy all those jerks. And then completely fail because those idiot droids managed to drag the bomb down. Yeah, this is going to get really irritating. You need to charge at that gap. Come on! I am so sick of you guys respawning. Let's try this one more time. Grapple the bomb. And now, fly across. There we go. Release and destroy the wall. Jeez, that took much longer than it needed to. But every cloud is a silver lining because destroy this pile, and we get another mini kit piece. Very cool. So in this cavern, we have a bunch of different things that we can destroy, as you can plainly see. But we want one in particular. By the way, this is also a double store zone. One of these containers is hiding a mini kit. And admittedly, I don't know which one it is. There it is! Okay. That brings our total up to 6. And I think we are ready to move on to the next area. Now, you would think the Millennium Falcon would be faster than a snow speeder in this frozen environment. But no, the speed remains constant. Yeah, I don't understand it either. All right, now before we do anything, we need to take care of the AT-ATs, particularly this one, because as long as it's on the field, it'll constantly blast the bombs that we need to destroy it. And that was an epic fail. Let's try that again. Around and around. There we go! That wasn't very hard, now was it? So now we gotta take care of the other one. For the record, I do have invincibility equipped, and it is going to help a lot because, yeah, laser fire. Need I say more? There we go. And with the AT-AT destroyed, the snowbank is gone as well. So we are all set to blow up a wall. Like so. How awesome is that? Now, if we go over here and destroy that container, we get yet another mini-kit piece, which is very nice. However, we're not quite done yet. We need to transform into a TIE fighter and go through this passage. Now, I don't believe there is anything over here in this area, but there will be at the end of the tunnel, as indicated by the green arrow over there. Yep, this is the area where we can find the power brick. So we, once again, must switch to a vehicle with the tow cable. And we're going to quickly go through here and get a mini kit piece. Awesome. I nearly forgot about that one, truth be told. And that was an epic fail. What we actually need to do is destroy that wall over there. And unfortunately, there are so many things that we could potentially run into. Oh, and there's the other mini-kit piece. I almost forgot about that one as well. All right. I apologize for not having uploaded a video lately. I mean, I really haven't had a schedule ever since my hours at work changed. So, it's been very awkward, to say the least. Yeah, I have a day job like everyone else. But, I don't know. It's just, things have been very awkward due to work and the coronavirus going around. Speaking of which, I hope everyone has remained safe. And I encourage everyone to please stay indoors and not leave if... And just don't leave unless you really need to. And if I could... There we go! I got the power brick, finally. Alright, we only have one mini-kit piece left to obtain. And it's a relatively easy one to get. I just have to make sure that I'm in the right area. And no, this is not the right area I need to be in. I need to go one back, and here we are. So roughly around here, there should be some AT-ST walkers that will spawn momentarily. I wonder if it will work on these guys. Oh yes, it will! We need to drag 10 of them to the ground, and once we do that, the mini kit will appear. So we don't even need to go into the final area. That's kind of how convenient this is. Well, I guess that's not 100% true. There is one mini kit piece in the final area that you will need to collect, but since I already managed to, get it during my initial run-through in story mode, well then, I don't have to worry about it. Alright, so we're up to 6 now. And beautiful, I'm suffering from lag. Just what I always wanted. After a while, the walkers will respawn. There we go. This should be number 7, I believe. And... yeah, you'll need to destroy the walkers in order to get them to respawn. Once you destroy them, 3 more will appear. Alright, so once we deal with these 3, we should be good to go just about... Come on! Will you go down already? There we go! That is all 10. We are done on Hoth. At least in this chapter. And now we get self-destruct as a power brick, or power up, provided by a power brick, I should say. And what a shocker. The mini kit is none other than the AT-AT Walker. Another golden brick to add to our collection. Very nice. So with chapter 1 finished, we are ready to move on to chapter 2. And at last, we'll get to walk on solid ground for a change. So starting off this level, we will want to use the force on these diagrams here. And once you do that, you will find that they show the outline of a mini kit. I wonder what this could mean. Big shocker, once you complete all four, you get a mini kit. And I only managed to collect one in my entire run through of this chapter in story mode. So needless to say, I've got some work to do. I'm probably gonna have to go through the entire chapter. Now this area admittedly does not contain a mini kit piece, but it does contain a helmet station, and it contains a money-making machine. So it's a nice way to get a little extra cash. Well, that is it for this room. As usual, move forward, and we have a charge to build. And this is yet another level that's really good for farming studs because of the many charges that you will undoubtedly encounter. And since the imagery of stormtroopers holding carrots was so funny, I decided to keep the imagery by having the snowtroopers hold carrots. Now right here you can use the force on the chairs to earn some extra cash, and you can also destroy the tables, but we don't really need to do that. No collectibles in this room, so we're just going to move on to the next one, as soon as the ice melts, of course. Alright. I cannot really think of anything else to talk about because, well, this level is pretty standard as far as levels go. Now, I should clarify something. Although the disarmed troopers upgrade will affect the snowtroopers that are on foot, it will not affect the ones in a blaster turret, so they will be able to shoot at you. Just a little FYI. So heading into this room, we're going to switch to Captain Tarfles, and we are going to jump up and find a minikit piece, which I apparently already collected, I guess. By the way, although he doesn't appear capable of doing so, Captain Tarfles can in fact block blaster fire with that shield of his. He just can't deflect it. As usual, we need to steer the cart to the other room because I don't think a thermal detonator can actually destroy all of that debris. I don't think it can, because if that were the case, then studs would have emerged from the destruction. But it's important that we head this way because there is a minikit piece waiting for us. First, we need to switch to our good old buddy Bossk, who is a bounty hunter, and destroy both of the shiny objects. Very, very nice. And we've got some lamps that need assembling. And once you destroy both of them, two skeletons will emerge. Well, that's not quite true. You still have to construct them. But you will need these skeletons in order to step on those switches for you. That is the reason why there are four of them. And once all four have been stepped on, a mini kit for you. Well, they certainly seem happy. But let's go ahead and move on, shall we? And we're gonna need 3PO for this one. Alright, there are quite a few things that need to be done in this room. First of all, a bunch of stormtroopers. So be careful if you don't have any upgrades available, because they will be swarming you. Alright, with that done, we need to switch over to Bossk, because although it doesn't appear to be so, this is in fact a breakable object that can only be shattered by a thermal detonator. And there is a minikit piece behind it. Very easily missed minikit piece, I might add. So in here, we have a door that needs to be opened by R2Q5. I'm not really sure where he comes from. I think he's an astromech droid that patrols the Death Star. In any case, there are some snowtroopers that are ice fishing. I never knew they were interested in that sort of hobby. Well, I guess it really isn't all that surprising, given the fact that there were beach troopers. But in that hole are pieces for a minikit piece. And that brings our total up to 5, which is very, very nice. So moving right along, we have one more minikit. Well, actually, two more minikits that need to be obtained. That one that we just collected, I didn't know the Jedi could actually reach it. Oh, a snowman. How precious. So what we need to do is we need to push this battery through that door, because that is where the other minikit piece lies. And admittedly, this one can be a little bit tricky to get because of how you need to place the battery. See, although it appears you can push it forward, you can't. You have to push it ever so slightly, like so, until it's in its proper slot. Then, ride the draft to collect the minikit piece. Awesome. So that brings our total up to 7. We're making some pretty good progress, I must say. Now be warned, as soon as you jump into one of these turrets, you will get attacked by snowtroopers. Now you could ride these platforms up, but it only leads to a blue stud protected by a Sith cage. Then again? Oh, never mind. I was just about to say you weren't ambushed, and here I am getting ambushed. Like I said, a ton of enemies in this stage. Thank goodness they're all disarmed. So we're gonna go ahead and build that panel, get rid of these guys, switch over to 3PO, and we are good to go. As usual, watch out for these white panels because they will fall. They are traps, if it wasn't completely obvious. All right, next room. A pretty simple one, and one we don't need to spend a whole lot of time in. You know the drill. Walk up the slope, hit all of the buttons, and the way will open. It's going to take at least 2 slides in order to get it. So just be patient and, well, try not to slide off the edge. And if you don't have the stud magnet, I wouldn't recommend going for the blue studs as they're too close to the edge. Alright, in this room, we are getting very close to the end. So once again, we must push the batteries onto the switches so that they will stay pressed. Yes, it's one of those pressure switch puzzles everyone loves in The Legend of Zelda. Perfect, the door is open. But before we go through, We're gonna need C-3PO's help to open this door. Because in here is a double score zone. Quite a few of these double score zones that we've been encountering, I must say. Believe it or not, these are shiny objects. So throw a thermal detonator and watch it go boom. And that's good because in this room, check it out, there's a minikit piece in that container. So once we build the panel that controls it, the protection will lower and we can collect the minikit piece. Very nice. We could use the force on these drawers, but it really doesn't do anything other than give us some extra studs. And man, we're almost up to 21 minutes. So we better end this pretty quickly. All right. So in this room, we have a couple of mini kits that need to be collected. And we will do that once we get rid of all the enemies. And the power brick is also there as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to head back and we'll need to switch to a Sith in order to take care of business. We need to build these platforms and hop across them. But be careful because this slope is rather slippery. And if you step onto the slope, you're gonna have to start all over again. Jump again, and we've made it! Hooray! A few more enemies to take care of, but nothing too special. Now we have two options here. We could go to the left, or we could go to the right. So we're gonna go to the left, for starters. Get rid of both of these. And we're going to grapple up to a lovely little snow globe area. I must say, this definitely has a calm serenity to it. We're gonna switch over to Boba, crawl through the other side, and collect the minikit piece. Now, if you want, you can use the Force to shatter the glass, but you will get attacked by the stormtroopers. And there really is no point in shattering the glass, so we're just gonna head back down. Alright, with all of that said and done, we need to use R2Q5 to open this door. And check it out, we are in the control room. Now this is kind of unique. Did you notice the colored patterns on those doors? Well, when we pull this lever, the slots will spin. And our objective is to get the colored circles to appear. Once that happens, the corresponding door will open. It is completely random and it can take a while. And somehow we managed to get both on our first try! Well now, I certainly wasn't expecting that. I have had times where I've had to pull that lever, I think, about 7 different times before I finally got both of those doors to open. But with all of that said and done, go through here and collect the final minikit piece. Go through here and collect the power brick. We are done. So with that, we have unlocked fast build. Very, very nice. Extremely helpful upgrade right there. And we have once again surpassed 4 million in terms of stud totals. And this mini kit piece is the snow speeder. A very adorable looking snow speeder, I must say. We also get another gold brick for completing the mini kit. Very, very nice. And I think we are ready to end the video because we are nearly 25 minutes in total. So next time on Let's Play LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga, we are going to continue collecting mini kits in episode 5. See you guys next time.
Hey, did you like what you saw? Then be sure to follow me on Facebook and Twitter for updates on my videos. Also, do you want to record LP videos like me? Then check out my kit page for my go-to equipment for recording.